Hey there, and welcome to Self-Health Fitness. Today we're going to do a performance overview so you know what to expect when you sign up at selfhealthfitness.com or if you just plan on watching the free videos that we're going to give to you every week at 9 a.m. on Wednesday. Here we go. Alright, so what we've got here is a little example of how we're going to explain to you how Self-Health Fitness looks to help people who are looking to increase their performance activity. Okay, so performance would be strength, speed, power, agility, balance, all those sorts of things. We've got a few others. So it doesn't matter whether you're trying to increase your performance for sport, hobby, or lifestyle. The key thing that you have to remember is that alignment wins every time. So that's what we're going to talk about today in a brief explanation. Okay, and as we go on through the weeks, we'll kind of break down each one of these so you can understand it a little bit better than how to maximize them. So, well, what is alignment? Alignment first, just so you understand what it is really perfect posture. We want to get your spine, your hips, all of your bones exactly where they're supposed to be. A lot of people don't know that your bones are actually levitating and it's the muscles, ligaments, and tendons that are holding them in place. Okay, so it's not the opposite way around in your bones. And understanding that is going to help you, again, increase your alignment to better perfection so that you can get more out of all these things. So, well, what do I mean by increasing alignment to increase these things? Well, you have to understand is that if your alignment's out, you're going to lose strength, you're going to lose speed, power, agility, balance, torque, you're going to lose your ability to breathe, and your hormones aren't going to work as well. So let's break this down even more. Now, from a strength perspective, when I look at strength, to me, strength is kind of the movement aspect. You want to be strong in everything you do. So strength to me is kind of almost a blanket term because anybody that wants strength, we almost always have to work in some of these other areas to get them stronger in whatever range of motion they're trying to complete, okay? The key thing that you need to understand is that, again, if we focus on your alignment, then you're going to get more strength. Now, what does that mean? Does that mean that we're going to be doing different exercises? No, not really. Alignment training means that we still do the same exercises that you guys are used to and have been doing all these years, except we put a focus on your alignment, not on getting pumps. The problem with getting pumps, okay, is like, let's say I'm doing curls and I get a bicep pump. Well, the pump is actually telling me that I'm creating an imbalance. That's why I'm getting all that achiness here. It's letting me know, hey, you're dominating this part of the arm. The problem that you and I have is that from an alignment perspective, our arm, you know, really starts at the center pec and goes all the way to the fingertips. Okay, and there's even more to it than that, to be honest with you. So when we look at, this is why when we talked about mobility, we say fascia tissue is king. It's the same thing with alignment. Really, fascia tissue is determining your alignment, and because of that, it's going to determine your strength, your speed, your power, your breath, all of these things. Okay, so that's why it's not that we're against you guys getting pumps, but getting a pump or specifically working on an area needs to be something that your trainer has told you to do because you're trying to fill in a spot, or maybe you're a bodybuilder. If you're a bodybuilder, this doesn't really matter to you because you're going to try to get pumps no matter what, and I just want to help you have a better alignment while you do that. But for the average person, you really don't want to get pumps. You may not have known this up until now, but getting pumps is really getting away from what you're trying to do because you want to, the better that you get your alignment, the better you're going to feel. The more speed you're going to have, power, breath, the better your hormones are going to work, okay? So from a power perspective, I call this the dead point. Power to me is how much power you have from pulling something from a dead stop. This is why with speed, I consider it coordination and power together, because coordination is your balance, your ability to balance through something. So if you have extreme amounts of power and you have great balance, you're going to get a lot of speed out of those two things, okay? Breath is your core. A lot of times breath, I would say, is the least used thing by clients and trainers to maximize their mobility, their performance, and even their nutrition in some cases. By understanding your breath, you're going to maximize your core. What's great about using your breath is it actually will help you refigure out how to use your core. Okay, so we're going to do a lot of videos on how your breath should work, why breathing is so important, and how to breathe through exercises. One thing that I always love to show people is that there's a lot of exercises that I'm really good at, and it's not because I'm an athlete. It's because I know how to breathe properly, and it makes the exercise a lot easier. So I'm going to teach you guys those things, and then you can go show your friends and show them this hard exercise that maybe you guys couldn't do, especially when it comes to balance. And once you've got your breath down, it's like, whoa, that's crazy. So agility to me is range of motion. Okay, so agility, again, if you have great agility, good range of motion, you're going to get more speed. Okay, so at the end of the day, you want to be able to move through everything. A lot of times people are getting hurt because they get that quick step, that quick fall, they move quickly and they don't have the agility to move through it. Okay, torque is joint flexibility. the thing that we don't, that hasn't been taught in fitness mostly, has been that we need to really torque our joints. What's been happening in the fitness industry for many years now is we do point A to point B exercises, and it's not really it's not helpful to the body because the body doesn't function this way. It's not trying to move things from point A to point B. You know that in your daily life, you're not moving things from point A to point B specifically all the time. There's generally other curvatures add to it and just other things that you're doing, okay? So the way you train in the gym generally does not reflect the way you live your life. And that's what we want to get you more balanced to, is training in the gym to more reflect how you live your life so that you can get out of the aches and pains that everyday life is causing you, like sitting all the time or just whatever the case may be. So torque is really that joint flexibility. So as I turn my wrist, I'm creating torque through this joint, okay? You'll notice you have a open joint, closed joint, open, so it goes back and forth, the body's pretty cool. So from balance, again, we talked a little bit about it, but it's coordination, okay? So the more balance and coordination you have, it's gonna really reflect mostly in speed, okay? And that's why we wanna have strength and agility to help our balance. And again, you can see all these guys kind of work together, but then they all have their same little portion. We could add other words to this and break it down even more. For today's purposes, we're just, as an overview, doing it this way. And then last thing is hormones and stress. You know, when we do alignment training, the best thing about it is it resets your spine, it resets your hips and shoulders. The more you get those reset, you know that your nervous system is coming from your brain through your spinal cord, you know, and through your spine throughout your body. So it's like we know that the thumb is connected to the spine, you know, the pinky is connected to the shoulder. So by getting you better alignment and helping you focus on alignment, we're actually gonna reduce the stress that your body's incurring by just standing there. And that's gonna reduce your cortisol. And a lot of you guys, if you know what cortisol is, the stress hormone, it can eat up muscle, it can make you hold fat, it can really be a lot of the main issues as to why maybe you're saying, I'm trying everything, but it's not working. Well, it could be that you're trying everything, but the way your focus and perspective as to how you're training yourself is not where it needs to be, okay? So this is just an overview. I hope this makes sense. Again, when you sign up at selfhealthfitness.com for performance training, let's say you're just wanting the performance training, now you know our focus is on getting your alignment better. Again, we're still gonna be doing a lot of the same exercises that you've always done. Now we have a lot of other exercises that we're going to introduce to you that are going to allow you to work through multiple planes and be more 3D exercises that you might say, because we want to get you covering as many planes of the body when you're exercising as you can. But that doesn't mean that we can't teach you how to deadlift for alignment. You know, there's a way to bench press for alignment. There's actually a way to do everything for alignment, and I'll tell you that about 99% of people have no idea. This is why we're trying to remake the standard. The standard should have always been alignment. Look at all the back pain that we have. If you go to our website, we got some statistics on there with all the back pain and all the problems that people are having with their sleep and just how it's messing up their work and all this stuff. And it's because there are a lot of times when people are going to work out, it's not motivating because they're going in there and training like a mini bodybuilder. And if you look at bodybuilders and how they train, it's a whole life thing. And so they get these pumps, you know, and they focus on getting their shoulders, and before you know it, your back's hurting more. Because you didn't realize that you needed to use alignment training when training your shoulders so that it would stay balanced. Okay, now you've got a back issue or something else going on, okay? So I hope this makes sense. Again, our goal is to focus on alignment every Wednesday at 9 a.m. We're gonna give you the focus and the perspective to do that by presenting you videos. Like, we're gonna try to keep them under 3 minutes. This one's gonna be a little bit longer because it's an overview, but under 3 minutes every week so that you know exactly what you need to be doing to get your alignment tip top. Thank you so much. We really appreciate your time, and we'll see you soon. Thank you.